Hi everyone, Ian here, and behind me is a new listing of mine in San Diego, California. This is the 2014 Marlow Hunter 37. So let me show you the features and benefits that this yacht has to offer. So here we are looking at the 2014 Marlow Hunter 37, and as you can see, this is one spectacular vessel. It has a beautiful painted hull with a gold boot stripe, gold cove stripe, and those really gorgeous modern lines that the Marlow Hunter gives you. As we work our way back aft, you're gonna also notice that we have a newer Dodger connector and bimini that houses the cockpit. We also have the stainless steel arch with the large traveler above head, and then also starting from about midship, that really low hard chime that carries all the way back here to the transom, giving you that stability and comfort that you're looking for when underway. The Marlow Hunter 37 also houses a swim step ladder that comes out from the transom here off to the starboard side, a locker here at the back, and a really remarkable drop down swim platform. The cockpit also is quite large for this particular model and allows really nice ease of single-handed use. I'm gonna walk you up to the foredeck, and as we go to the foredeck, also notice the built-in stainless steel grab handles here in the Dodger, and then also down below as you're working your way up to the bow, there's lots of large wide side decks here for, you know, great access up to the foredeck. We have a large anchor locker system here. This is a large Lumar windlass. This is a kind of a drip pan with all of the anchor chain and road going down below. And then our Lumar switches that allow you to retrieve and deploy the anchor from there. Looking back aft, you can see all of the sheets, halyards leading into the cockpit. I also want to point out that we have six foldable cleats here. The cleats themselves drop down, so they really have a nice clean look. Genoa tracks here up on the side deck, flush hatches, and again, this is pretty remarkable. This is a two spreader in mast furler with radar, and at the very top we have 1-point wind speed, wind direction, and also TV antenna. Looking back at the Dodger itself, this is the upgraded macro long glass, so it looks like you're looking through a windshield. A removable connector here, and then there you can see the large Harken Traveler on the stainless steel arch. Coming into the cockpit, we have, again, large bench seats here. This is a single helm with a folding Lumar wheel. There is a teak table here that will actually extend up, giving you a great cockpit table and space. Also, the famous aft stern rail seats that the Marlow Hunters give you, and this amazing drop-down swim platform. You can just imagine yourself, you know, out at Catalina Island with this drop-down, having good, easy access right onto your dinghy. All right, looking at the helm itself, again, as I mentioned, the Lumar folding wheel. Here at the helm pedestal, we have the autopilot. The autopilot, again, gives you full function. This is a below deck linear autopilot, so it's a much stronger upgraded autopilot from the wheel mounted one. We also have our engine controls, a side power bow thruster, something very unique on this size of a vessel, but this will give you that peace of mind when docking to have access to the bow thruster. Wind point, wind speed, depth, speed, and then above we have the Raymarine hybrid touchscreen GPS display with integrated radar. It also has AIS built in as well too, and that's where you can see all of these AIS targets as well. Cockpit cushions are quite nice. The other thing I want to point out is we have these really cool Lumar electric winches. So this allows us to control our port, starboard, and ease off. So depending on what tack you're at, you can actually ease off the jib sheet or reveal it in. Again, making this vessel super easy to single hand. Up at the cabin top, again, all the sheets, halyards are led into the cabin top off to the starboard port side. We have really nice little bends for all of the halyards and sheets to kind of house themselves into. And then coming down below, what I really like is these large stainless steel grab handles here and a really nice ease companionway steps. The galley's off to the starboard side. We have a two burner stove and oven, microwave oven. Below that is a built-in freezer that can also be control down to be a refrigerator. We have our, again, oven, microwave, Look at this storage here, large Corian countertops with stainless steel grab handles built in here. We have a top loading trash can, beautiful deep stainless steel sinks underneath this Corian countertopper, and then our refrigerator. Lots of below storage as well too. And that's one thing this galley does not lack is space and storage. Directly across from us is our aft head and shower. And then our nav station. But again, I want to show you the ease of access coming down the companionway. Engine room is right underneath this, you know, built-in box here, which allows us side access, rear access, and top access as well too. And if major work is being done, this does unscrew so you can gain access to the engine. All right, so directly across from us, let's go to the nav station. Here we have the stereo CD player, disc player. We have our 120, our 12-volt electrical panel breakers, our Outback inverter charger. We also have the ICOM 504 VHF, our Raymarine smart controller. This allows us to operate the autopilot and also visually see depth, speed right here. But you could be on the bow of the vessel driving the boat, if you're out there single-handing, putting your dock lines, fenders on. We also have a tank monitoring system here as well too. This will allow us to look at our water and our two water tanks and our one waste tank. All right, so directly across from us, so expanding out, I'm going to show you the air conditioning heating controls here. This beautiful teak wood interior that Marlow Hunter has brought into the elements. A large U-shaped seating with upgraded upholstery here. It is quite nice. Overhead, there are two opening hatches with screens and shades on them, a flat screen television mounted up on the forward bulkhead, and a large bench seat off to the port side. We also have Bose cube speakers here, nice built-in grab handles. And what I really love is this, you know, two-tone where they've done the teak, this kind of board that kind of makes that transition to this kind of material that they use. It is really classy and quite nice. Now coming up into the V-berth, this is a really roomy V-berth here. You can see just how much real estate we're working with. Off to the starboard side, we have hanging lockers, shelving, top storage area, lower shelving here, a nice V-berth, and it actually, the pillows are blocking, but that's where your feet would go down into. Overhead opening hatch, a nice little bench seat off to the port side, and another hanging locker here. So again, really nice use of space. I love how they've integrated that two-tone into the door. They've also brought the mirror here, so it just gives you that sense of, you know, that volume into this cabin, which is pretty remarkable. All right, looking aft, you can kind of see a little different perspective of how much volume is in this particular boat. This table itself will also drop down and turn into a bed if so desired. And again, this countertops, this attention to detail, I mean, it is quite nice what we're looking at. All right, I'm gonna first take you into the head compartment first. So we have a separate shower stall from the sink and vanity. The vanity itself has a mirror that will fold up to allow you to have a medicine cabinet here. Stainless steel sink, the same Corian that's found in the galley. Storage underneath that. And then we have our walk-in shower compartment. Now, when your shower is in use, you have the plexiglass door that will enclose this. Then you have a shower curtain that will close over the door. And this is a electric, you know, a vacuum flush toilet. So a push of a button, and that is really nice. We also have access into the aft cabin there. All right, I'm gonna walk you through this way so you can kind of get the full experience into the aft cabin. So here in the aft cabin, this is a queen size berth. We have our headboard on this side. Behind the door here, we have a hanging locker closet. We have an opening hatch there. And what I really like is, you know, what they've done is they've opened up this. So instead of creating another locker with low headroom, they've raised this up. So you have great headroom here. You have ventilation. Your feet are underneath here. But across from us, we have a TV and a separate air conditioning heating controls there. A great walkway over to our additional storage and then our access into the head and shower compartment. Pretty impressive. And to note, we are also on a 37-foot vessel, which is very remarkable. Well, I know we covered a lot of boat in a short period of time. I hope you found this to be helpful and informative. If you would like additional information about this particular vessel, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tuyl, at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. Thank you again.